All right. Welcome, one and all, to the famous Dungeons & Dragons podcast, which we don't know the name for yet. We'll think of it later.
Yeah.
These podcasts are probably going to be about an hour long, maybe another 30 minutes, depending on how long we feel.
That's a long podcast.
Yeah. Well, today, our cast might increase, but for today, we got our three people. We got Hannah Martin. Hannah, would you like to say hello?
There's a dog licking my leg.
Okay. Hannah's audio is a little whack, but we can still usually make out what she's saying, so if you can at home, good for you.
Okay.
That's about it.
All right.
So, we've already made our characters and everything, so you don't have to listen to that boring nonsense.
Yeah.
Get straight right in.
So, since we only have two people playing, I created an NPC to play with them.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully, he'll be helpful, and you won't meet him immediately, but he'll be around.
Okay.
So, Simon, would you like to introduce your character?
I'm going through some name changes. So, originally, my name was Taco.
All right.
But spelled T-A-A-K-O.
Okay.
Then I remembered that's from a thing. So I'm trying to think of an original name, but it's hard. So maybe more of Martin the Wizard. Like, first name Martin, last name Wizard. Middle name the
Martin the Wizard.
Yeah.
All right.
But I think I'm just going to go with Taco the Wizard.
And
just steal their name.
Steal it anyway.
Yeah, because who cares? They're not going to watch this.
No.
If they do, I'm sorry.
No, that's good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to write it back.
All right, and
That's spelled T-A-A-K-O.
You already said that.
I just want to make it clear.
Make that very clear. And Hannah, you can introduce your character.
My name is Hempel. Spelled Hemp. First name Hemp.
Yep. That's it, all right.
I have a lot of abilities. Like, play metal on my loop.
That's pretty great.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. Well, I guess we're good to start.
Yeah. Oh, well, I guess, we'll meet the other character later.
Yeah. You'll meet him later. So, we begin with our two adventurers.
Oh, yeah, my character has a voice, too.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Thanks, Simon.
I just wanted to... It's a little high-pitched.
Oh, no.
No, it's not that voice.
Okay.
It's a good mid... It's more like the voice I was doing
for Fry.
Yeah.
Yeah!
Yeah, it's a little bit of both. It's Taco, the wizard. Alright.
He's doing a face, too. He looks uncomfortable.
Yeah. Alright.
Alright.
You ready, Zach?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Alright, sorry for interrupting you.
Okay. We begin with our two adventurers, Taco and Hemroid, on a ship.
Mm-hmm.
It's in the dead of night, very early in the morning. We have no idea what time it is.
It's at least 7 o'clock.
It's past 12, but it's before 12.
Yes!
All right. So, you've been traveling.
Yeah.
To...
trying to get some, just those travel miles up.
Yeah, right. So you can get a free boat ride.
Yep.
You've been traveling to the other shore of the continent. It's in a U shape. So it's pretty, pretty easily accessible. You just sail across the little U part.
Ah, yeah.
There you go. So you're going to investigate some odd goings on in Corvus.
Corvus.
Which is one of seven large cities scattered throughout the continent.
Mm-hmm.
And each city has a hunter, a warden, and a priest. The hunter goes and seeks out threats and evils beyond the cities. So they live out in the wilderness. They're like your typical rangers, guys like that. The wardens stay inside the city and defend it with city walls and the guard and, you know, homeland security, basically. The priest is there to devote their time to light and healing and purity and blessing the countryside.
Is this all in, like, the brochure that we got?
Yes, exactly.
And the travel brochure.
Well, like, you already know this.
We're sitting there reading it together, just like, they only gave us one to share.
Yeah. Okay. So, in Corvus, well, actually, we'll get to that in a second. So, you're on this boat, and it's very stormy. And the boat is rocking, and it's turning, and it's tossing around in the water, and it's just gray and gloomy and rainy outside.
Mm-hmm.
And you're trying your best to keep your footing.
Yeah.
It's very difficult. A sailor that's obviously used to this rocking of the boat walks up to you, and he puts a hand on your shoulder, and he says,
"The captain, Taylor. Hi, I didn't see you there. How do you go? How do you go, sailor?
How do I go?
How do you do?
I go well. It's storming.
Yeah.
Sailors don't like storms.
That's too bad.
The captain wants to see you.
Oh.
And he's on the other side of the ship.
The other side?
The other side of the ship. He specifically asked you to go to his quarters.
All right, better roll to run.
Roll to run. So
I had an eight.
I'm not gonna make you roll for that. So you successfully make your way across the ship, and you knock on the door, and he throws it open, and he looked like he was about to come outside and find you. He's wearing his overcoat and his captain's, you know, three-pointed captain's hat, like
as
sailors
do.
As captains do. Per usual, and he stops and he says, "Oh, well, come inside then." And he gestures you in.
I say, "Come inside where? Eh?"
Into my quarters.
Oh, okay. Alright.
Jesus.
Look, can I roll for shame?
No, God. Alright. So, there are a couple chairs for. Sitting, if you would believe it. and he gestures you to sit down, and he pulls out a map, and he slaps it down on the table.
Wow, very,
just a slap, big old slap. Big guy, he's a large man, this captain.
Yeah.
And he unrolls it, and he points at Corvus on the map, and he says, "So.
Is that where we're going?
You're going here, right?"
Sweet.
Okay, yeah.
We'll reach Corvus by tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
What you should know...
Yeah?
...is that about 6 weeks back... ...their priest went insane.
Wonderful.
Bonkers? Crazy?
And he started performing very dark rituals and experiments on his own time. He wasn't harming
any
citizenry.
Because, you know,
I
dark?
I don't know. It was different times of day. He didn't harm anyone. But, the church still wouldn't allow it. So they told him, they gave him a chance to stop. And they said they would kick him out if he didn't. And he didn't. Mm-hmm. So they kicked him out. And he left the city.
Did he like, post 58 rules? Like, of why he thought the church was dumb?
So...
It was good reasons, first of all.
That night, he managed to take all of his experiments and research with him. Another thing you should know is that he was performing these experiments on humans. And so the citizens of Corvus started noticing...
Well, that's okay. I'm an elf. I'm safe.
Shut up. The citizens of Corvus noticed dead relatives that had come out of the grave and were walking around again.
That's pretty good. You know, see your grandma. Make her... She's like,
a lot of strange things started happening in the countryside around Corvus.
Yeah.
So he was replaced with another priest.
Yeah.
And then everything was going fine until about 2 weeks ago when the hunter disappeared.
Hmm.
You're going there to replace him.
Both of us? Like a 2-for-1 deal?
A 2-for-1 deal.
Ah, 2-for-1 deal.
They need extra protection.
I hate the... I'm not going to do the voice anymore.
All right, that's fine.
I gave up.
So, basically, it's dangerous.
Yes. Sorry, I had chili for lunch.
It's understandable.
I actually did.
Basically, yeah, I believe you. It's dangerous. Be careful. You have no idea. No one really knows what you could possibly find when you get there.
Wonderful.
But I wish you the best of luck.
Thanks,
for
you.
For now,
I kind of feel a little deja vu. It's kind of odd.
Well, okay, well, sorry.
Like, this has happened before.
Really, has it?
Yeah.
All right, well, you know.
Maybe it's like me in a past life.
It's possible.
Maybe me as, like, a lady that was, that's, like, somehow... Or is that the one where I got goblin STDs?
Oh my god, I remember that. No, that was not the one.
No,
we haven't played this one before.
Because it sounds a little familiar.
The beginning, that's... Yeah.
Okay.
We haven't played this one.
Okay.
So, he says, I would recommend that for tonight you try to get as much sleep as you can, and we'll reach Corvus by early morning.
Alright, that sounds good, you know? So, alright. Where are our sleeping quarters?
On the other side of the ship.
Great. We're walking.
So I'm assuming you're both going.
Yeah, we trot. I squat walk.
Okay.
It's where you squat.
Both of you...
And here's a kick. You walk.
Shut up. Both of you roll a perception check.
Well, here's the thing. I get +2 on perception.
All right.
+2.
So, Hannah, you can check that
plus
app.
+4.
If you just scroll a couple times, you'll see the different skills and stuff that you have. And then you can look at perception. And...
Well.
Is that your roll?
Well, it's 2 plus 4, so a total of 6.
All right, so Simon gets a 6. And since Hannah doesn't have dice,
you roll for Hannah.
So what's
4.
Your perception, Hannah?
Perception?
Yeah.
1.
Okay.
Okay.
So Simon gets 6 and Hannah gets a 5.
Do I notice that in any way, or does it stay that way?
Yeah, well,
it's just a check, so.
Okay.
When you reach level 5 or 6, you'll have a chance to add some points to your skills and stuff. But
I
mean,
no, she's just talking about that one dice roll.
Oh well, yeah, that's just the one. So Simon gets a 6, Hannah gets a 5. You notice literally nothing. You're staring down at the deck of the ship.
I'm just
dumbfounded
with my mouth open, just like.
Yeah, you're trying to keep your footing and you're waddling around, just trying to survive until you get to your sleeping quarters.
Mm.
Well, I mean, you make it successfully, but, you know,
yeah. You
don't see anything. Around you, you hear a couple of the sailors gasp and stop moving, and, like, they saw something interesting. But it goes right over your head. You have no idea.
Hmm.
So you reach your sleeping quarters.
Sweet.
The next morning, you awake to bright light. Coming in from
above, bright in here.
Above decks.
Wow.
And the boat is rocking very gently. Like it's stopped somewhere. It's no longer, you know, being thrown around by stormy waves.
Yeah.
So the world is yours. You're free now. What would you like
Sweet.
To do?
Sweet. I'm going to stay on the boat.
You're going to stay on the boat?
I'm
going
to stay on the boat.
I'm going to buy some fruit.
Okay, I won't stay on the boat. Let's go into town.
Okay.
Let's go into town.
Alright, so you go above the decks of the ship,
yeah.
And the captain, you see the captain standing with his crew on the deck, and he's handing out little sacks of coins, and he's, you know, looks like they're about to have, you know, a night out on the town, getting a break. I'm sure there are plenty of brothels to hold them all. And you're the last ones on the ship, and the captain turns around and he says, like I said, good luck to you both.
Thanks, man.
And if you get into a spot of trouble,
yeah,
I'll be here to take you away. You know who to come to.
I don't.
That sounds kind of creepy, but okay. Thanks, anyways. Bye.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye, Togo. So, okay. All right. So around you, you see this neat little town.
Yeah.
Very tidy, small houses. It's obviously a port town. It's a fishing village, but it's pretty good size. A lot of ships are docked, and they're coming and going. Crowds are walking around, and people are buying and selling. There's a tiny market, but it seems like most of the wares that you'll find here are in some of the better shops.
Yeah.
Oh, you both started with 10 gold, by the way.
Oh. I already gave us gold.
How much did you?
15 and one platinum.
No,
and two cup.
You get no platinum.
Fine. All right, 10 gold.
10 gold. I have a reason for that.
Okay. Hannah, change, add 10 gold to your character sheet.
Okay.
All right, so if you want to look around in the town, you can.
Okay.
That's it to you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, we got 10 gold, so...
All right, so...
Sorry that chili didn't set well with me.
Nothing does.
No.
So, what are you guys looking for, then?
You know, I got a proficiency with some swords, so I might as well get a short sword for some close-range attack.
All right.
Yeah.
You don't have one?
Right. No, I just got a staff. Quarterstaff.
Oh, okay.
I think
sure.
I want some armor.
Something. Armor? Yeah, because we don't have any armor.
Well, yeah. You should. You should have an armor class.
Yeah, but you said that we don't start with any armor.
No, I was saying you do.
Okay, good.
Well, I mean, your armor is, like, built into your character.
Okay.
So you don't, like, that's where you get your armor class from.
Okay.
So. All right. So you're looking for a short sword?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you see, like, immediately on your right, you see a little smithing forge
mm-hmm.
in a little shop, and you would assume that they sell weapons there.
Yeah.
You go in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you see there's a stocky...
I do that.
No, a cliche blacksmith, stocky black-bearded man behind the counter, and he's leaning on it, and you walk in, and he says, "How you doing?"
I'm good, sir. How about you?
I'm doing.
Yeah?
What can I do you for?
Do you by chance have any, short swords in stock?
You mean like a short sword or a short sword?
Hey, I catch your drift there, Sonny.
No, we have short swords. It's fine. We have some
okay.
behind the counter here. How about this one? How's this one look?
And he plops down a fairly good quality for such a small town. A fairly
yeah.
good quality sword.
It's a good sword. What are you selling that for, good sir?
How's about I give it to you for 2 gold?
Two gold? That sounds amazing.
You folks look new.
Yeah.
All right, you can take it for 2 gold.
Thank you, good
so
sir.
So you've got 1d6 plus whatever your proficiency bonus is.
Okay.
So plus 2, I guess.
Sure.
How you doing, young lady?
I'm good. Do you have any shields?
Some shields. Yep. We do. There's a whole wall of them over there. How's about you take a look at those? And you see a range. It goes from crappy wooden shields that are just, like, nailed together to some fairly nice, intricately carved steel and iron shields.
I'll
take
the one with the most spikes on it.
With the most spikes? Okay.
Kind of like a weapon shield, yeah.
He takes one down, and he hands it to you, and it feels pretty good. It's pretty well balanced. You think you'll be able to throw this thing around in combat. And he says, "All right, how's about you take that one for 2 gold?
Sounds good. Here's your money, dude.
All right, I like the looks of you folks, so...
Thank you, sir.
You ever need something, just come on back through.
Of course, yeah.
And he shuffles around back behind the counter.
Such a nice man.
So, Hannah, what that shield is going to do It'll raise your armor class by 2 when you have it equipped. And if the enemy, when the enemy's rolling to hit you, if it lands on the exact number that your armor class is, you'll do damage to it as it damages you. So that's pretty cool. Most shields don't do that.
Yeah.
All right. So what's your armor class going to be now with that shield?
So did you say, how much did you say it was?
It gives you a plus 2. All
right, so it'll be 15.
15? Okay. And you have 15?
For what? For armor class? Yeah.
That's a lot for wizard.
I don't know. But what is it supposed to be?
Oh, you didn't do that on the app, did you?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, for wizard, it's going to be like 11.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's a wizard.
Yeah.
All right. Cool. So, he waves goodbye as you leave the shop.
Bye, sir. Have a nice day.
And as you leave, the day is warming up. You can smell the sea breeze and the little marketplace. There's fresh food, and you can smell horses.
It smells like horse.
There's a team of carts a little ways down the road. It looks like that you can hire them to take you places.
Places.
Like that one place that we were supposed to go. Where was it?
Like that.
Corvus. Do they have a brothel?
Do what?
Oh, no.
Oh, I didn't hear what you said. Okay. So, I'm drinking.
Just chill. Trying to find.
All right. You notice while you begin slowly walking down the main street, you see there's a guy leaning against the wall of a building, and he's flipping this black coin, and it has a square cut out of the middle.
I squint at him just like...
It doesn't look like anything you've ever seen. Does anybody want to give me an insight roll?
Insight? I don't have insight.
Don't have insight, so that's just going to be your straight modifier.
My what?
Your wisdom modifier.
Okay.
Oh. Plus 2. Which is 2, so that's fairly good.
11. 9. Plus 2, so that's
11.
Yeah.
Why don't you roll for Hannah, too, just to see if she does better?
11. Hannah, do you have a wisdom modifier?
I have minus 1 insight.
Okay.
Okay, so 10.
Yours is better.
Yeah.
You have no idea where that coin is from. You've never seen anything like it. And he just looks odd. He looks out of place. Not dangerous or strange.
It's just like all the buildings are like white marble, and he's just like wearing a black cloak.
Well, he is wearing a black cloak.
Ah.
He's flipping a black coin. And he's wearing gloves, and his hood is kind of pulled
over.
Sir, see his.
Where's that corn from? Chris,
corn.
Where's that? You got any corn?
He looks up, and he stops flipping it, and he catches it. And, cool guy, am I right? Whoa.
Yeah.
And he,
look pretty cool, sir.
He stands up, and he puts it in his pocket, and he says, well, if you've never seen one, I can't rightly tell you where it is, but...
Oh.
You know?
All right, yeah.
Why... Shit.
Flicking things everywhere.
So, how about both of you roll a charisma check? Just for kicks.
Okay. This dice is not lucky. I'm gonna hold up.
7.
No, hold up. I'm gonna use my lucky dice.
Roll, alright.
A little better.
Okay.
A little better.
Roll for Hannah.
Alright. Hannah, what's your charisma?
My charisma is... Shit, where is it? I remember it. Somewhere. I have it somewhere.
Either way, she gets it.
Yeah.
Well, you got a good roll. You got a 19, so.
Ooh.
So he started to turn around like he's gonna walk into the alley, and then he turns back and he looks at you sideways. And he says, you know what? Why don't you two follow me real quick? And he gestures at you to follow him, and he walks just a few feet back into the alleyway.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so he He takes out this little bag, and he opens it, and it's not very big. I mean, you can fit your hand inside of it. It's like a coin pouch.
Maybe. I stick my hand inside of it and grab whatever in there.
He slaps your hand before you can do that. And he says,
sorry.
Wait for me. And he puts it on the ground, and it just looks like the size of a little coin pouch. And he puts the toe of his boot in there.
I saw this in a movie once. There's like a Harry Potter movie,
his
right?
entire leg disappears, and he swings his other one over, and he starts to climb down what must be a ladder.
Yeah, it's like, it's like Newt's Commander, and, you know, like, mythical beasts and where to find them.
I did not see that
movie. Oh, it's actually really good.
Oh, okay.
I like that. He has a suitcase where he walks down on a ladder to go somewhere, yeah. Okay.
Well, I mean, this is...
It's a pouch, so it's different.
A bag of holding. They're in D&D, so...
Oh, yeah.
They're very rare, though. So, and you see his hand pop out of the bag and just...
I grab the bag collar. And zip it tight. Before he...
Do you really?
I kind of want to do that and just take him with us on our journey.
I mean... He can't really stop you.
Yeah, I do that. Before he reaches his hand out, Or he has his hand out the entire time.
He already put his hand back in after he waved to you.
Okay.
So you just take the bag.
Yeah.
All right then.
Okay.
So you write down in your items list.
All right, I'm gonna
bag of holding with man inside. Now remember, he can only survive for an hour in there.
What do you
mean? That's part of the rules.
Yeah.
Living creatures can only survive in
what
a bag
if I,
of holding.
What if I give
him
a little air every once in a while?
That's fine.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna actually do that once an hour.
You have to drop him food.
Wait, are you gonna do?
So you have a pet human.
Are you gonna do food in this campaign? Because I don't.
I'll just assume that you like to eat and survive.
Yeah. And assume that I also drop him
a little
snack every time I can't find my pocket knife. So
that's pretty fantastic, Simon. I was not expecting that to happen, but all right. So now you're standing in an alleyway with a bag of holding.
Hold up. Where do I? I don't know. I'll just put it here. I don't know. I'll just put whatever.
Yeah.
Bag of holding with
God,
man.
I was not expecting that, but you know what? I probably should have been. Okie doke.
Hannah, we got a man. I mean, not a Hannah.
Hemorrhoid.
HR, I'll call you HR.
We have a pet.
HR, we got a pet man. Pet How man. You doing in there, sir?
There's no response.
It's like, he must not like me.
Probably not.
Yeah, but now I got a man.
What kind of food do you like? What do you need?
There's no response.
Do you like corn?
Clap once
sir?
If you're dead. Clap twice if you're not dead.
Wait. He's ignoring you, basically.
Yeah, I don't think he likes this, Hannah. HR.
Maybe he's just busy.
Yeah, he's jacking it.
His back. Okay. So you can...
Okay, let's go to where we're supposed to go.
All right. So you...
Does the bag have any, like, inscriptions on it? Like,
no.
Nothing? It's just a... Is it black?
No.
No?
It's just a... It looks like just a tiny brown coin pouch.
Okay.
It's almost indistinguishable from your real coin pouch.
That'd be kind of weird, like I drop the coins. Hold up. No, I grab something from my, what is it? It's not my, it's the other pouch, Scholar's pouch.
Okay.
I grab a pen and quill and write, and do a little star on my coin pouch.
Okay.
So I know which one is my coin pouch.
All right, cool. So, there you go, walking like a gunslinger with two coin pouches at your belt. So you continue down the main
road. One is jingling a little bit, and the other is just like books falling over. You're just like, ah! You hear a little... Okay, all right.
So one of the wagons that I mentioned earlier has left. The other one is still there, and there's a guy climbing into the back. But,
you know,
the,
HR,
the
I hope...
Driver,
I hold up. You know, I hope he didn't have any family.
No, he doesn't.
Okay.
Don't worry about him.
Okay.
The driver leans
over. Wait, actually, I might want him to die, so...
Really?
Yeah, so I can steal all the stuff. I can see what's in there. Actually, you're giving me that look that I shouldn't kill
him.
So I probably will keep up.
Well, I'm just giving you the incredulous, would you really do that look? But okay. So the driver, as you're walking by that the wagon, he leans down and he's like, you know, we've got room for a few more in the back. We're going to Corvus if you want to get your ride.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Really?
All yeah. Right. You got room for three? And I wink at him.
Well, I suppose, yeah.
Okay.
Where's your third person?
Oh, sorry, it was just a joke. Never mind.
Okay.
Sorry, well, I'm...
Climb in back.
It says on my personality traits that I'm real sick for jokes.
Does it? Okay.
Yeah.
I don't understand what you're talking about. I'll take your word for it.
Shout out the first fourth wall in the first episode. Three times.
Right. Okay. We'll get in back and we'll head on to Corvus.
Okay.
All right.
So, the wagon starts off, and the dirt road is soft. It seems freshly paved. It's a very nice day. The clouds are parting overhead. It's about still fairly early. I mean, you got off the ship just a bit after dawn, so it's probably 7, 8 o'clock in the morning over by now. He's driving for about a half an hour, and the guy that you saw climbing into the back before you, he takes out a
Sorry, the beans. It's the chili.
He gives you a look, but he doesn't say anything, and he takes out a lute, and he starts to strum.
Ooh.
That's about it. He seems pretty good. No.
God, he's good as
hell. Zach, you can strum.
Okay. So you hear...
So it sounds a little out of tune. Do you want me to tune that for you? Are you mute?
Oh. No. So,
may I interest you in my lute playing?
I would love to hear your lute play.
Sure.
Not you, Hannah.
Oh, Hannah. Hannah. I mean, HR. We gotta call her names.
That's my lute.
I thoroughly enjoy a good lute.
So do I, yeah.
So he continues...
A good looting?
He continues to, you know, just strum and look around. And suddenly the wagon kind of lurches forward, and it stops pretty suddenly.
You put on the parking brake too fast.
And you can hear the horses out front kind of dig their hooves into the ground, and the driver kind of... he says something, but you can't really hear him. So you've stopped.
All right. Like, are we here?
No, he seems a little distracted. No, there's a bit of a problem.
Yeah?
If you'd like to come look, I don't know.
Hold up, what's your name, good loot man?
My name is Bran.
Bran. Oh. Like the cereal.
I suppose, if you'd like to look at it that way.
All right. How do you do, Bran?
I'm faring quite well. I wish our carriage would keep moving, he calls out to the front.
All right, what's up, Mr. Carriage Man?
How about you just walk around and give it a look yourself?
Sounds very suspicious, but okay.
Well, I don't know what to do with it. You look like adventurers.
Okay. I do that.
All right, so you hop down, walk around to the front of the wagon. There's a guy sitting in the road, on his hands and knees, facing away from you. And he's not really moving. He's just kind of sitting there.
Mm-hmm.
And he won't move.
Hey, HR.
Yes.
Can you pick him up?
Sure.
Roll for a strength check.
Okay.
To pick him up.
Like a bride.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so... What's your strength, Hannah?
I need to stop rolling on this because it doesn't roll.
My strength is 14.
What's the modifier?
That'd be 2, right?
What?
I'm pretty sure that's plus 2.
Yeah.
Okay. So you got a 19. So, very successfully, she walks up and graciously scoops this man up like a bride. and looks into his eyes.
Is he all drunk?
and realizes there's something a bit odd. His eyes have... They're brown, but they have a bright orange rim around them.
Oh, I've seen this in a movie. It was,
I don't get all of my stuff from movies.
So. I know. It's more subconscious.
He's
Doctor Strange.
He seems very limp, and he looks back at her, and he's completely emotionless. And then she realizes that there is a massive hole in his stomach, but it looks old. And the front of his shirt is torn, and it's got dried blood on it, but it looks like it's been here for days. And he seems perfectly fine. Mm-hmm. There's no response from him.
Yeah.
Holy shit, what happened to
your
stuff?
Can I roll to loot?
To loot?
Yeah.
Sure, I mean, you don't have to roll.
Okay, loot.
I mean, he seems pretty passive. he's got nothing.
Like, can I steal his clothes?
Huh?
It's like bloodied clothes with a hole in it?
No, he's
wearing
them. It'd
be a fun party guy.
He's wearing them.
Okay.
So he kind of squirms, and he's fighting against hemorrhoids' grip.
I think he's alive.
I'd say
we might
so.
Have to roll for an initiative check really soon.
Hey, Taco, can you fit your hand through the hole in his stomach?
Actually, that's a good idea. I stick my hand in the hole in his stomach, just like wiggle it around.
He slowly looks around and looks at your hand, but there's not really a response. He's still just kind of struggling, kind of. He's being all squirmy like a cat that
can
doesn't want to get held.
Is he ticklish?
I don't know.
Okay,
sorry.
I'm not gonna tickle him. That's gone. I'm sorry.
And he manages to like weasel his way out, and he kind of flops onto the ground, and he gets up, and he's crawling very quickly to the side of the road. And this is your first time out of the carriage, and now you're noticing that there are a few farms dotted here and there along the countryside. This road passes through a very open area, so you can mm-hmm. see for miles. And there are some farm animals.
For people who don't know what D&D is, we're going to take a quick sidebar since it's kind of at the 30-minute mark.
Okay.
Actually, finish your thought.
All right. So as he's approaching one of the farmhouses, he's moving very quickly.
Yeah.
About three or four cows that notice him, they kick out and they squeal and they run as fast as they possibly can away mm-hmm. from the guy, just blindly in the opposite direction.
Mm-hmm.
And he continues on towards the farmhouse.
It's like, should we do something or, nah, it's fine.
The driver calls down, he says, well, he moved, I suppose you can get back in now, if you wish.
Yeah. All right.
Sounds good.
We do that next time after the break. Hi, and welcome to the Dungeons & Dragons podcast, which we're going to name after this. I'm probably going to name it at 11 o'clock, 3 days from now.
For Dicks and Dragons.
Oh, Dicks and Dragons.
I was thinking Doofuses and Dragons.
I was thinking
Dungeons & Doofuses.
Dicks and Dicks.
That's a good idea.
Just dicks.
Just dicks.
Dicks.
It's just dicks. It's just
dicks.
Dungeons.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah. Okay.
So
no dragons.
So Simon wants to get back in the wagon.
No, this sidebar's still on. So we're gonna explain D&D for people that don't know what
they already know if they're watching it.
No, most people find this on Facebook via my mom.
All right.
Hi, Mom. I love you. Hannah, no!
I'm not trying to hit on your mom!
No! Don't hit on my mom. That's weird and gross. Anyways, Dungeons & Dragons is a tabletop game where you roll dice based off of random stuff. Okay, this water right there. Okay. Give me more water.
I want my water.
Okay, Dungeons & Dragons is a tabletop game where you roll various dice depending on certain circumstances. The whole object of the game is to have an adventure with your buds, your pals, anyone. So...
Even your mom.
My mom doesn't like to play, sadly. But it's fun to listen to. So the whole point of it is usually it's turn-based, sometimes it's not. And we're... Imagine living in a book. Where there's certain character arcs and different things and, you know, things happen. Usually in the first episode, nothing really too extreme happens, but by episode 50, you could be crying. You could be emotionally attached to Taco, the wizard. That's his last name, the wizard. Anyways, that's the sidebar. This episode is sponsored. This episode of
sponsored by Wizard.
It's just Dungeons. Sponsored by candles everywhere.
So if you're a company that sells candles,
you know who to call. Hook us up.
All right. So your sidebar is over.
Sidebar is over.
So Simon, what are you doing? You getting back in the wagon?
I get back in the wagon.
All right, Anna, what do you want to do?
I stare out for a second, and then I slowly get back into the wagon.
All right. So after a moment of pause, she follows Simon back into the wagon. The driver kind of looks oddly at the man, who is now crawling up the front stairs and is reaching out for the door handle. The wagon starts again.
Hold up.
What?
I'll check something. How far away is he?
By now he's probably about 40 or 50 feet away from this, from the road.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Hold up, I wanna see how... Just a second, sorry, I don't have it pulled up.
What are you looking at?
Magic missile.
Okay. It's probably 60 feet.
Yeah.
Spells. Do you know what damage it does?
I think so. There it is, magic missile. Yeah, it's 120 feet.
Oh, 120 feet.
Okay, so it's 3 1d4s. So, so I cast magic missile on him.
Okay, roll to hit. Plus your attack modifier, which is your proficiency plus your intelligence.
Six. 12.
So 12?
Yeah.
Okay, you hit.
Okay.
Two.
And each of those is plus one. So three.
10.
Okay.
So this, he's kind of leaning out of the back of the wagon, and well, what does it look like? What do you do?
I just point my wand and, you know, I guess.
Just fucking do it.
Yeah.
All right. So,
nothing fancy.
Three large purple darts arc out of the end of his wand and streak very quickly right towards the guy. I'm assuming you're in.
Yeah.
So, they each just slam into his back and throw him against the front door, which crashes inward.
Mm-hmm.
And he kind of shifts and he gets up and he looks over his shoulder. And he starts...
I stick my tongue out.
...scurrying on all fours as fast as he possibly can towards the wagon. And he's completely silent while he's doing it. He looks pretty beat up, though. Like...
Yeah.
So, everyone roll initiative. Good job,
Yay!
Simon.
Yay!
You started a fight.
Well, I didn't want those people to die.
Good point. Yeah, you can see the family crowding into the doorway trying to see...
I got two.
Wow.
I'm not lucky today.
11. Go ahead and roll for Hannah.
13. All right,
so it'll go Hannah, Guy, Simon.
Okay.
Cool. All right,
so from here, he's still about 30 feet away from the side of the road. You can run up to him if you want, or you can just wait for him to get to you.
Can I run up to him and try to grab him by the leg and flail him around?
Yes.
Is that like a, is that's like a brute force strength?
That would be a grapple check, which
okay.
is strength. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so go ahead and roll a d24.
14.
Wow, yeah.
Plus strength is 2.
So that'll be 16, yeah. So you see this drow barbarian just barrel off the side of the road through the tall grass, and she just grabs him around the ankle,
mm-hmm.
and she lifts him up and starts slamming him around into the ground.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't seem to affect him that much, but she has effectively stopped him running.
That's good.
So that's her turn. Now it is the man's turn. So So what was that, 16? Yeah. He tries to, like, weasel out of your grip again, and he's clawing at you, and he's reaching up, but he just can't seem to get a hold. He misses every time. Mm. So now it's back to Simon.
All right, I run over to Hannah, and, let's see. I use Chill Touch on...
Now, was Magic Missile a spell or a cantrip?
That's a spell.
Is a spell?
Yes.
Okay, well, that's used one of your spell slots. Cantrips, yep. you can use as many times as you want.
Yep. All right, I use Chill Touch.
All right.
Which is 1d8.
Okay.
So our roll...
Plus what? Plus six?
Plus six, so that's, I don't know, a number? 10.
10, all right. So Chill Touch, you have to actually touch them, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So he runs up, and through the creature's flailing and screeching, he's screeching now, he's not silent anymore. Hannah kind
Do
of
I hit?
Holds him out,
yeah.
And Simon grabs him. Your proficiency.
Wait, yeah, this is D8. Yeah, four, so proficiency 2.
Okay, so yeah, 4. And he grabs the guy around the throat, and he just kind of, like, icy blue light seeps out of his fingers, and the guy stiffens and just hangs limp.
Sweet.
So you think he's probably dead.
Hannah, we did it.
Yay.
Do you want to be sure, though? Because it is your turn.
Can I just toss him into, like, a ditch or something? Just, like, hold his ankle, just toss him in there.
Yeah. So she's still holding him and just kind of disgustedly just tosses him over her shoulder. And he happens to land in just a muddy pit that the wagons make when they cross through the road.
Is he just, like, Terminator style, just, like, slowly falling into the mud?
Face down, like, sinking, and it's making farting noises. Like, it's... It's as unflattering as could possibly be.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay. So the driver kind of looks at Simon.
I give him the thumbs up.
And he frowns, but he nods, and he, you know, throws a thumb back over his shoulder to tell you to get back.
Okay.
All right, so the wagon keeps going, and it goes through the day, and you guys stop to eat, and you eat, and you eat successfully without dying. Congratulations. And the day passes without anything else happening.
Mm-hmm.
Roll perception again.
2 for me, and 8 for Hannah.
Okay. So... At one point, Hemroid, after staring at the road passing behind the wagon for who knows how long, looks up and notices that a dog is walking the opposite direction that the wagon is going. And he's just kind of staring down at the ground, and he's just plodding along really slowly. But she notices the same strange orange ring around his pupils as the man had. But he doesn't react to the wagon. He just keeps going as they pass each other. Other than that, the day passes fairly uneventfully. And by the time the sun has started to set, you can see Corvus. Mm-hmm. And it's very close.
Can I talk to the loot man?
Yeah.
I mean, Bran?
Yeah.
Yo, Bran, you know... what are you going to, Corvin for?
Well, I've got a performance in Corvus. Tomorrow night, actually.
Ah. Thanks for correcting me. I forgot what the count was called.
I'm fairly well known around these parts.
Yeah.
I'm a storyteller.
Hmm. What's your, genre? Like, horror, mystery?
Adventure.
Ah. See, I'm more of a horror guy.
Okay. Yeah. Well, there are plenty horrific adventure tales, I assure you.
Sure, there's some crossover, yeah.
Will I be seeing you around in Corvus? Is that your destination?
Yeah, it is, right? Yeah. Yeah.
Interesting. What are you doing there?
We're actually being employed by the state. You know, They got these things called protectors, I think they're called.
Nope, but good try. You're the new hunter.
Like a little voice pops in my head. It's like, the hunters! The hunters! Yeah, the protectors.
I see. I haven't heard of this group, but...
Yeah, yeah. They sort of deal with magic stuff, I guess.
Interesting.
Like, yeah.
You have... Oh, there goes the other ear.
Oh, thanks. You did it.
I stepped on the... Cool, okay.
Yeah.
I'll hold it like that, then. TC says, so you've heard what's been happening in Corvus, correct?
I've got a general idea. I know it's pretty bad.
Bad things, yes.
Bad hurt. Bad man do hurt to
That's
good
right.
people.
Well, I wish you the best of luck. And he hops out, and you realize the wagon is pulled up to the gates. But it's very dark at this point. Late at night, maybe 10 or 11 o'clock. And you're hearing very strange sounds coming from in front. You're still about 100 feet away from the gate, so you can't really see what's happening. There are torches lit all around this high stone wall that surrounds the city.
Yeah.
And you can see guards running around on top, and two or three at the very front, hanging over the gate itself, are aiming bows down and firing into the darkness.
Are they flame bows so we can see where they're firing?
No.
It's a shame.
It is a shame.
Is it close by?
About 100 feet away. But to the gates. And that's where they're above the gates on the wall, shooting down. So, there you go. Bran kind of looks worriedly at you and he says, should we do something?
You know, I kind of want to see what's going on. So... Yeah?
Do you have that?
I do.
Okay.
All right, I cast Dancing Lights to try to see what's going on.
So is that a cantrip?
It is a cantrip.
I see. Okay. So, what do they look like?
They're purple. Actually, no, they're green. They're green.
Oh, wait, well, you're both elves, right?
Yeah, but I'm a high elf, so I don't get, I see infrared, I think.
Like those areas?
Right?
Or?
No.
No, I don't.
You can both see.
Okay, yeah.
Never mind, I totally forgot. Well, Bran can't see what's happening, so he's looking at you worriedly. You see a mass of about four, I don't know, it could be 5 to 10 different shapes, and they're clawing and scratching at the front gates. And some are being shot down, but some are just, like, taking the arrows like a man. They're just full of them. They look like porcupines at this point.
Okay.
Should we walk around them or beat the shit out of them, Taco?
Well, you know, I don't know. I've already used up one of my spell slots, which wasn't the wisest.
Depends on how big these things are. So we either climb up ourselves or...
We do have to get through, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, yeah, I mean, they're...
They're shut down our path.
There are other entrances, but since the city's so large, it would take you a little while to walk around to the next one. There's one on each of the four cardinal directions.
So, how many people, how many figures do you...
You roll, roll investigation.
Okay. 8 plus 2 and investigation. It's intelligence. Plus 4 to that, too.
Okay, so 12.
Yeah.
You can tell that...
No, 16. Because it's plus 2 and 4.
Not plus 2, you're not proficient.
Yeah, I am.
Oh, yeah, you are. Okay. So you can tell that the pile of bodies at the bottom of the gate is maybe 3 or 4, and there are another 3 or 4 scratching at the gate. So there aren't as many as you originally thought there were. And they're still being shot by the guards. Another one goes down as you're watching.
Okay. Well, we could wait it out, you know. Or we could help. But at the same time, try to be like, hey! You know. What do you think, HR?
Well, sure, let's go for it.
Alright. I guess that means roll initiative.
So you're gonna just run up and...
Yeah.
Okay. So the two adventurers, with Bran kind of shuffling along behind them, having no idea what he's walking into, they run right towards the group of what could be people. You have no idea. And they, three of them turn around and they look at you. And they, two of them just kind of start walking towards you. But one, who looks like an older guy, just goes batshit and runs right at Simon.
All right. Do we get a... No, they, I think they get...
Well, he's not attacking, so there's no saving opportunity. Okay. He's just going to target you, basically. So go ahead and roll initiative.
I already did. I got 14, and I got 15.
God damn it.
Does he trip right. over just trying to initiate attack?
What's your name? Taco.
Taco.
Okay. So the old man does not do anything at all to Simon. And it's... He just whiffs. He misses terribly. Simon sidesteps like a friggin' ninja. And old guy just kind of goes face first into the grass, but he gets up again. So, Hannah, your turn.
Can I grab him by the scruff of his neck and slam him into the ground?
You have weapons. You have, a great axe. You can slice him in half.
I guess...
Alright, yeah. I'll just do the first thing then.
Alright. So that's for her great axe,
yeah.
Right? Alright, so that'll be proficiency in strength, which is 4, so 16.
I should actually just get her a character sheet here.
It's not a bad idea.
Just to have.
So great axe is a D8, I'm pretty sure.
10.
D10? Okay.
So. Right hand, D10?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's 12. That's 10. 10.
All right. So she, since it's even though she's an elf, it's still pretty dark. And This old dude's being a squirmy worm, and he's running around, going crazy, swiping at Simon and missing every time. And she just kind of heaves in the general direction she thinks he'll be, and happens to take off one of his arms and a massive chunk out of his side. And he notices, but for some reason, he's still interested in Simon.
I think he's got a thing for me.
Yeah, probably. So now it's your turn, Simon.
He likes skinny elves. Okay. So... Hold on. Let's go first. Mess up. So... how close is he? To me.
Right in front of you.
Right in front
of
you. Okay,
within
so...
Within melee distance, which means if you use a ranged attack, you'll be at disadvantage.
Okay, so I use my... short sword.
Okay.
So, let's see. Which I'm proficient with.
You hit.
So that's a D6. Where would be this? 3.
Okay. So you, Simon, stops him by just stabbing a short sword through the guy's chest, and he dies, instantly. That one's down. The other two have reached you. One is a,
sorry,
an old lady. Possibly the wife of the old man. Who knows?
Sorry, we killed your husband.
And the other one is just a burly-looking bald guy. And the old lady screeches inhumanly and jumps...
Like that?
No, God. That was humanly.
Oh.
Because you're a human.
Fair enough. No, I'm not. I'm an elf.
No, you're not. You're a human. Shut up.
Fair enough.
And she jumps at Simon. What's your armor class?
15.
All right.
No, 11.
She hits.
Either way.
All right. So, that is 4 damage, Simon.
Jesus Christ. Can I take a...
I'm sorry to say...
So, I got... Wow, that's a lot of numbers. 3. Yeah, I'm gonna take a good step back.
So she knocks him down and just sinks her claws into his shoulders and just starts going to town on him. Now, the burly guy looks at the burly barbarian and thinks this might be a good match, mayhaps. And swings at her with a little dagger.
I'm gonna pimp slap that guy.
Probably, yeah. 13, he misses. So, he doesn't do anything, Hannah.
Okay.
But, out of the dark, from behind those two, in the direction of the gate, a little guy is running full tilt boogie at the entire group. You have no idea who's intended target he's going for, like, good guys, bad guys, you have no idea. Until he jumps up and sinks a rapier into the back of the bald guy for 5 damage.
Okay. All right. Can I... Is it my turn or...
Back... Yes.
All right. Can I take my shield and slap the bald guy with it?
Yeah. All right, so go ahead and roll for her stone.
5.
Plus 2, because there's no proficiency with shields. Hannah, I'm sorry to say you missed.
Whoops.
She swings wildly. It's a heavy shield. And for such a big guy, and after getting stabbed in the back, he seems oddly dexterous. And he moves. So, back to Simon.
Okay.
Who is on the ground, getting torn to shreds by this old lady.
Okay. Can I roll to push off the old lady?
Yeah.
Actually...
I gotta be cold like it.
Okay. Oh, let's finish the battle. Okay. So, I take my short sword, and... I attempt to jab it into her.
Into her? Okay. Yeah. And, Yeah, go ahead.
17.
Yeah, you hit it.
Okay. That's a d10. Wait, that was a d6. D6 is that. 2. Yeah, it says so.
Plus proficiency. So.
Oh, 4, yeah.
All right. Alright, so she climbs off. She's not interested in maintaining.
Can I run away now?
Any longer. Yeah.
Okay, I run away a little bit.
But because you're in melee range with her, she'll get an attack of opportunity if you run.
Can I walk?
Stupid. So you can risk it, or you can just stay.
I stay.
Okay. So, bald man is still tangoing with hemorrhoid, and he swings that piddly little knife at her again. And this time he hits. Yeah. For 4 damage.
Okay, yeah. Hannah.
How much health do you have, Hannah?
13.
Okay. Then... So yeah, down to 9. You're still faring better than Simon is.
Okay. I'm like bleeding.
Old lady.
I'm a tiny man. I'm a skinny boy.
Yeah, you are. Old lady looks around. She doesn't know who to attack, and she thinks, why not? Let's go for this guy again. And she jumps at Simon a second time. And she hits. Whoa, you're lucky for 2 damage.
Ugh.
You are barely alive, my friend.
I'm just coughing up blood.
So this guy is torn to shreds. So what you now can see is a halfling in a little powder blue cloak. Takes his rapier, and instead of attacking, points it in the direction of...
Hey, Mr. Arrowman, why'd you stop? Like, you haven't shot any during this entire fight.
What?
I'm talking to the Arrowman, the archers.
They're still... well, they kind of ran out of range, and they're still dealing with the guys at the gate.
Oh. They're just like... sorry, we just took a 5-minute break.
Took a fiver. So, the little halfling, mm-hmm. he's got light brown hair and a little powder blue cloak. He waves in the direction of Taco, and soft blue light envelops the wounds. And he heals for... Oh, shit. That's the wrong dice. For... Crap, what's my... I believe that's 8. So, yeah, you heal for 8.
Sweet.
That's all... That's everything you lost.
I'm just like, I feel refreshed.
Yeah, 8. Alright, so you are back to full health.
Got a bag of baby carrots. Just like... All right.
So back to Hemorrhoid.
I swing my axe at him again.
All right.
Hopefully.
18.
Oh yeah, she hits.
Yeah.
All right. Going to do damage.
I guess. 10.
Wow. Okay. So, she can see the pattern in this guy's bobbing and weaving, and she cleaves him at just the right time, and he goes just perfectly in half. And obviously dies. So there goes the bald man. Simon, your turn.
I attack the old lady again with my short sword.
Okay. Roll again. It bounced.
Okay.
You have.
What?
You have.
Oh. So.
Because proficiency. 1. Let's do is 3.
Okay.
So. Angry, Taco just lashes out with a short sword and he manages to, like, slice off a couple of her fingers.
Fuck you, bitch.
She's definitely having second thoughts about attacking this guy. So instead, she's gonna turn around at their new adversary and she's going to scratch at the little halfling. And she... She misses.
Hmm.
Alright. So then it's the halfling's turn. In response to that, he's gonna swing. Wow, okay. I'm not even gonna bother with that. He missed horribly. Back to Hemorrhoid.
I go up to Grandma and pimp slap the shit out of her.
Bap!
Right across the face.
Alright.
5.
It was a poorly timed bitch slap, and it sails above the old woman's head, but it looked very threatening.
Wow, that's really threatening. Good job, HR.
Thanks. All
right. Back to Simon.
Okay. So, just a little reminder, just a little refresh. The old lady's still alive.
Mm-hmm.
Bald man?
He's dead.
And... that's it?
Yep, that's it.
Just the old lady? Well, I don't know.
Before Taco can do anything, the old lady drops to all fours and backs up and whines like a dog almost. And she scurries away and looks back over her shoulder once before disappearing off into the darkness.
It's like, yeah, that's right, get out of here! But I feel really insecure about it because I don't have a high charisma.
It's not very threatening. alright.
Wait, I have a high intimidation. I got a +2.
Oh, okay.
Well, so I got a +1 intimidation.
Then it is threatening.
Sweet. Yeah, take that. But in other... without intimidating, I'm not very charismatic.
Yeah. Alright. So, the creatures are dead.
the guards wave at you, and you can just, since you're pretty far away, you can just faintly hear them call out, "Come inside!"
And I say, "Come inside what?" And I wink at him.
The city. Oh!
And I give him finger guns.
He gives him back. Your little halfling friend and Bran.
Hey, bud, what's your name, little half bud?
The halfling bows graciously.
Sorry, that's a little racist. I'm sorry. Says, I didn't really. I'm sorry. I didn't mean it.
It's all right. I am little. He says, "My name is Joge Adurn."
Got a nickname?
Joge? That's my first name. You can give me a nickname. How about that?
How about Joji?
Can I call you Josh?
I like both of those. Josh and or Joji.
Let's go Josh. That'll be easier to remember. All right, Josh.
They follow you into the city gates, and as you walk inside, you're just bustled away by this group of city guard, and you don't really have a chance to see much of the city. There's a wall of men in white uniforms around you.
Are they congratulating us that we just had an amazing battle?
No, it's the KKK.
God!
No, yes, they did.
Yeah.
And so you go... You're basically walking along the length of the wall next to the gate, and you go up into a guard tower, and a very tall black man wearing a large city guard hat, who is very obviously the warden of the city. He turns and he shakes all four of your hands. And
I wipe mine before I do it, just to get the pre-sweat off, just like, "Hey, sir."
He says, "I thank you for helping protect the city."
You know, it's just our duty, just like, as helpful, friendly fellows.
I take it that you are the replacements for Roland.
That would be correct.
Interesting.
Where'd he go? Did he go take a walk?
We'll talk about that in the morning, after you've had a chance to rest. But, yes, of a sort. What is that face you're making? God.
It's like, did you get my funny joke that I just made face?
Well, he kind of did.
No, so, no, I'm saying you.
Yes, I got
okay.
it.
We played a song called Rolo Takes a Walk.
Well, his name is Roland, but close enough.
No, but I changed on my music to say Roland.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow, okay.
So that's that joke.
Well, he takes off his hat and he sets it down and he leans against his desk and he says, "We'll have a lot to discuss tomorrow morning. But for now, get some rest." And again...
Does he by chance have a jacket that I could take? Like the last time we took his...
That was a totally different person.
I know, but it's very similar.
It's about time to feed your man in the bag, too.
All right.
He hasn't eaten all day.
Is there any food around? Hey, do you have any crackers?
Well, I have bread.
Yeah, that'd work
I'll
great.
It's on my desk. Help yourself.
Thanks. And I take the bread and I break off half of it. Thank you so much. And I set the half back and I open up my pouch and just like slide it through there, and I tighten it back up.
He squints at you but doesn't say anything. And
I give him like the thumbs up. Is like it's you know.
He walks and he opens a little door in the back of his office and he says, "Your beds are just through here."
Thanks, yeah. I have to do some workshop on my voice.
Take as much time as you need to rest in the morning, and I'll send you to our priest to get some information on the circumstances.
Bye,
Roy!
Goodbye! Okay.
I love that voice. So I think that's a good stopping point.
Yeah. Just yeah.
Yeah. All right. Fair enough. We can play, you know, whenever over Skype.
Yep. All right. Goodbye. Join us next time, whenever.
All right.
Bye. We're signing off.